Ask Yourself Podcast, sponsored by Easy Excel. Excel VBA Chapter 1, Adding Totals. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Well, we're talking here in Chapter 1 about using the macro recorder. I've already talked about relative references. Relative references need to be turned on in most cases. Now, you can do that back here on the View tab. Macros use relative references, or on the Developer tab under Use Relative References. So you want to make sure that's turned on, has a nice glow behind it. We'll record a macro here that's going to attempt to add totals to the bottom of this report. I'll call it Add Totals 1. Ctrl+Shift+T, Shift-T there. Click OK. So the macro recorder is running now. We're going to use navigation keys, so Control down arrow to get down to the last row with data today. Down arrow one more time, type the word total, and then go over and hit the Autosum button, to add those totals in. All right, so that macro works fine. We get our answer of 6,000. Tomorrow, we get another data set, and we say, okay, let's run that macro again. So do Alt F8, click Add Totals. And because we used relative references, the total appears in row 10 instead of in row 7. So that worked out great. All right, but I mean, look at this. We have 8 rows of 1,000 that's totaling up to 6,000. When we go look at that, we see that it gave us the wrong formula. So here's the problem. Apparently, the Excel team, big team, the guy who does the macro recorder and the guy who does the AutoSum, they must not talk to each other, because the macro recorder can't record the essence of what the AutoSum is doing. So, you know, for a long time I was just like, oh, well, at that point we have to go write some code. I was in New York, Pennsylvania about 2 or 3 years ago, and someone there said, well, wait, we figured out a solution to this. And this is a great little tip here. He said, all you have to do is change this formula back here by one character. Change one character, and the macro recorder will get it right. The character is right here between the B and the 2. Put a single dollar sign. So that says, hey, always reach back to row 2, but then go to the row just above where you are. So let's record the macro a different way. So we'll come here. Developer, record macro, I'll call it add totals, take 2. We'll go Ctrl+Shift+R, click OK. Alright, so relative is still turned on because I haven't closed Excel. Control down arrow one more time, type the word total. But now instead of using the auto sum button, I'm going to actually type equal sum of B$2 colon B4. Notice there's no dollar there before the 4. And click enter. Press stop. Now here's the big test on Thursday. Have a different number of records set up here, and we'll run our macro. Alt F8, take 2, click run. All right, and the total goes to the right place, and the formula goes back to the beginning. All right, so a couple of rules as you're using the macro recorder. First of all, relative should be turned on all of the time. Microsoft should have turned that on by default. Everyone would have a much better experience with the macro recorder. Number 2, use the navigation keys to get down to the last row. So control down arrow will reliably get you to the last row. And then third, never, ever touch the auto sum button while you're recording a macro. You're just going to have a disaster. You should always find some other way to write the formula instead of using the auto sum button. So there you have it. That's our example here from Chapter 1. I want to thank you for buying the book, and thank you for working along. And each chapter, pickup. In many chapters, there'll be one example that we call out and say there'll be a video there. So the videos won't be covering the whole book, but just in certain places, adding a little bit of extra content so you can come out and see this example performed live. Okay, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.